We would like the auditor's presentation, please.
Do you have any problem if we just move that to last?
Not a bit.
Okay.
Good audio of it.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Ron Schranz. I am with Burton Company CPAs, the managing partner and the partner that supervised, reviewed, and approved the audit for the railroad. This was our first year doing the audit for the railroad. It is a fiscal year end of 6/30, and I'm happy to say that the railroad was in compliance with all the governmental accounting rules and auditing standards, and also the rules of the state of New Mexico for their compliance with reporting requirements and also timely filing of the audit report with the state, which was completed and delivered within the time frames of November 1. So in a series of items that I'm going to speak about, that's one of the first accomplishments and a very important accomplishment, because if you don't make that, there's repercussions as what we call findings in the report. The financial statements for the railroad are somewhat complex due to the requirements. And just briefly mentioning what that is that there's in effect two sets of financial statements, one on the accrual basis and one on the modified accrual or cash basis. There's reconciliations between those, and then there's footnotes, supplemental information, budget to actual information, and then an internal control report. Your job as the management for the organization is to have a internal control structure in place so that the financial statements can be prepared by you in a accurate, materially accurate, and complete fashion. My job is to then furnish an opinion on that. The way we do that is by using standards set by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants in the way that we test that information. We cannot test every single transaction that the railroad has done for the year. That would be time and cost prohibitive. So we use techniques such as sampling, analytical review, confirmations, inquiry, and observation. The outcome of that is we try to make a determination whether we have obtained sufficient evidence to form an opinion. And I'm happy to say that we did obtain sufficient evidence. Again, congratulations to you. It means that your accounting systems were functioning in a way that allowed us to do that, and you had review and control processes in place for us to rely on that information as it was tested. We are then able to form an opinion on the financial statements, and I'm happy to say that we formed an unmodified, or what we would call clean, audit report for you, meaning that the financial statements were presented in a materially accurate manner. And again, congratulations, because not all organizations get an unmodified or clean report, so that's a good thing. We also have to report on various other parts of the financial statements that are required both by governmental standards and the state of New Mexico, which is what we call supplementary information. We've looked at that, and again, we believe that is accurate and fairly stated in material aspects. Lastly, we have to look at the internal control structures as part of the overall audit. and determined that they are able to keep transactions in a materially correct manner, and if those transactions are not, that they're identified and corrected in a timely manner. We have included that report. There were some findings related to that, and I can get into that in a little bit more detail. The findings related to such matters of some accounting challenges regarding reporting of transfers. And there's, not to get too deep here in the technical accounting, if it looks like a transfer is going to be repaid, it's accounted for one way. If it looks like it's not going to be repaid, it's accounted for in another way. Those transactions were not accounted for in a consistent basis, so we've had discussions with management on how to correct that for the upcoming year. You have the railroad has a significant number of fixed assets. I'm not telling you anything you didn't know. Accounting for fixed assets when there is such a large number can be challenging. We did find some issues in the way the fixed assets were being accounted for. We made some recommendations on how that could be improved, and the railroad is moving to make those improvements. We noticed some posting issues with prior year audit adjusting entries. And so one of the things is we've made recommendations that any adjustments that come out of the audit have a process to make sure that they are timely made so that they're not hanging open going into the next audit. We've worked with the accounting department, and they are making those adjustments. And in fact, my understanding is they've already made those adjustments for the upcoming year. So that's a very positive aspect. There were some minor items related to payroll